Hello and welcome to the Class DLC released today, and we're going to break this up because there's quite a few bits of kit. So we're going to look at tractors first of all. So these are the beauties what we've got available. We've got two large, two mediums, and then one small. And the small, it's still big. It's got a lot of upgrades on this, so you can put it up to the 140 horsepower anyway. Now a lot of the tractors, well all the tractors, they've got a lot of engine configurations. They've all got pretty similar tire options with Trailbogs, Mitas and Nokians and Michelins as well. Now there are different variants where some have got twins and some haven't and that sort of thing. Now I won't show you all of them, we'll go into there all of them because there's absolutely loads, so it seems silly to. So first of all, we've got the Class Arion, and this is the 410 to the 460, and beautiful little machine. Got a front loader attacher on it as well, so that is an extra 1500 quid. I'll cover that on the extra attachments actually on the other video. And exception to detail, you're getting close to it, and it's amazing. It really is. All of this stuff is pretty amazing. I haven't really had time to have a good go with it, so I've just got it out and had a good look at it and done the write-up of what's what and how much it costs. So how much does it cost? £75,500 to buy, with your initial leasing cost at £3,850. It's a 24 mile an hour top speed on it. And let's go on side as well. Now slot count on all of this stuff is pretty high, which you'd expect, and this is -38. So the smallest tractor is -38. Now we have got some pedals, and you can see the lever action on the forward and the drive there. And I would have thought we'll have action when we put a front loader on as well, but inside looks pretty nice. Like the Class seat logo. Nice bit of kit. So that's the first tractor, and lovely. Now let's turn that back into the sun so we can just see this at the back here, where all the linkages and top job really is. Awesome bit of kit. So this one does start off with a 90 horsepower, and then it does go up in increments where you can go from 90, then it goes up to 100 horsepower for another £5,000, and then 110 horsepower, which is the 430, which is £10,000, then the 440 sorry is 120 horsepower. So it does go up in 10 mile an hour in 10 horsepower increments up to 140 horsepower, which costs you £25,000. But beautiful, nice to see Class here, it really is. So this one has also got the panoramic roof option on it, which I can't remember what that, it was £5,000, yeah it was £5,000 for that, which you've got that taken out of there, so you can see up at the stars at night, or even in the day you can see the clouds. But it's a little bit beefier than the other ones you can see. Well, this is the non-panoramic, and it just hasn't got that bit there. We still got a sunroof in those anyway. Now lighting wise, loads of lights are going on, and then obviously we're indicators and our beacons. But a pretty good set of lights on there. So that's number one, that's the little baby tractor. Then we move up to the 660, which is the next one up. Now this one will cost you £120,000 to buy, and your initial leasing cost is £6,120. -40 slots. So already these two, you know, we are up to 78, and we got them. So, and I tried to get all the stuff out yesterday on a first look stream, and on the map I was on, I couldn't even do it. I'm not sure if you could do it. I will give that a go later, maybe. Anyhow, so we've all got the trial monitors options on all of these, and the engine configurations go from 145 horsepower, which is the standard one, and then they go up to 205 horsepower, and there's four different increments, and it's £30,000 for the 660. But you're going inside this one, and then we've got the sunroof anyway, so the only thing you haven't got is that bar there. Started up and it all looks pretty nice, doesn't it? Well, it's brand new bit of kit, it's got to look nice. Heated rear screen there. I wonder if that'll work. And probably does work on PC on seasons, I bet you, but not on console. Oh no. But yeah, cracking that trailer, and it's got a front loader attacher on for that one as well, which it would be nice if these bigger ones have front loaders, but they never do. They're not made for it really, are they? So that's the Arion 460 and then the 660, which I've got the bigger ones engine wise out. Then we move on up to the 870. So we're getting a little bit more horsepower now. So we got 205 horsepowers and minus 40 slots again, 31 mile an hour top speed on it. And it's a nice size tractor. You can go up to, there's quite a few configurations on the engine. I think it was six different engines, and you can go up from 205 to 215, 235, 250, 264, and then 295 is the big bad boy, and that will cost you an extra £45,000 though. So they're not cheap, but we didn't expect them to be, did we really? Same again, these have got all the, actually these bigger ones have got all the options on the tyres, and the smaller ones have got a few different ones. But you can go in the shop, you'll see it all. I didn't want to go into it, otherwise it's just lots of options which are more or less the same for basically bigger and smaller tractors. But there you go. And this one, same as all the others, it drives. I just haven't been able to do any tractoring with it at the moment. I've just been doing other stuff today and really want to put it to the test and haven't been able to. So that'll be later on, hopefully. So that's the 870 Axion, cracking bit of kit, and I do like the names in the top there. So it is like, which one is that? What is that? Oh, that's the Arion, that's the Axion. Right, moving up to the Axion's bigger brother is the 920 to the 960. Now this one I've actually only got the 928, but same thing again, the horsepower starts off on this bad boy at 325 horsepower, so plenty of power there. £279,000 and £14,229 on your initial leasing costs. So there it is, 31 mile an hour. It was 31, wasn't it? No, 32 mile an hour top speed. Of course, it's that little bit bigger, isn't it? So it's gonna be. And they do all sound pretty similar. I haven't noticed any dramatic change with them anyway. So if you want to go up to the 445 horsepower, it's going to cost you 60 grand. And there are a few different other options. You can have 385 horsepower, 410 horsepower, so, and 355 as well. So quite a few. There's loads of engine configurations, loads of tyre configurations, but no colour choices, which you'd expect. It's class release, it's not gonna have colour configurations, only on modded stuff. A fair play, Johnston, good job. Nice bit of kit. Then moving over to the proper bit of kit. Now this is proper job, isn't it? And we got the 5000 Xeron, 435 horsepowers. Now only minus 35 on the slot count, so it's surprisingly lower, and that one actually is 38. So we got 35s, 38s, and 40s, and 30. Yeah, that's 35. So these will cost you £337,500 to buy. And what a bit of kit it is. £17,212 for your initial leasing costs. You can upgrade the engine on it. It goes up to 490 horsepower for £31,000. 250, or you can go up to 530 horsepower for 63 grand. Now, we have got quite a few different tyre configurations on the Trailborgs and the Michelin and the Mitas, and we've also got twin narrows, which I thought I'd put these one on because I haven't seen them before. So twin narrows on there, and you have got the wides. Obviously the wides are bloody wide. It's a serious pulling machine, but the beauty about this is that you can use it in reverse, where you can turn the cab around, for those who don't know. So go on into the cab, and yeah, that's the back of the seat, and we've got good visibility all the way around as well. Turn her on and our screens come on, and then we have got the lift and turn around function, just like that, and now we're that way. It's a nice little feature. Now, originally when I looked at the steering on it, I thought, oh, it's not that great, but it is awesome. It really is. It will turn on a dime. You can more or less go down the road. I'll show you. Go down the main road and you can more or less turn straight around on itself. I think it does glitch a little bit maybe, but let's get past this car. Yep, and you could if there wasn't a bloody lamppost in the way. So yeah, the turning radius on it is pretty good, especially for the size of it. It's huge. Can't wait to get it into use, get some ploughing done with it. I've been hauling a bit of grain with it, and it pulls like a train. It really does. Awesome bit of kit. Righto, well, that's it for the tractors. The next one we'll have a look at, I'm not sure actually, I'm going to go through and have a look, and we'll put them into, we might do the harvesters next, see what they're all about, because there's quite a few of them as well, and then we'll do the other implements and what have you. So righto, we will leave it there for today. I hope you've found this video helpful or useful or entertaining or whatever you want, really, but I just wanted to show you the tractors. There they are. Are you gonna buy the DLC? I got a season pass. That's the thing, you find after a year of farming sim, you'll just get a season pass, because everything what comes out, you want it anyway, so you don't want to be messing around. Oh, shall I have that? But some of it is a waste of time. But my opinion so far, this Class DLC, the expansion pack, is pretty awesome. It's the biggest DLC we've ever had. Anyhow. Right, well, if you've enjoyed this episode, don't forget to smash that like button for me. If you're new to the channel, why not check out one of my hundreds of other farming simulator videos. Got loads to choose from now. Crazy, mate, nearly coming up to 500. So have the next episode hopefully uploaded today, otherwise we'll get it uploaded today, so go and check that out when that comes out. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.